one of the things about vaccine trials, and we've talked about this before, so I'm going to give you a little bit of virology 101. And we've talked about this before, but to remind you, a vaccine is, think of like an M&M candy. It has a protein shell on the outside, and then on the inside is the RNA or the DNA, and in this case it's RNA, and that's what causes the problem. Your immune system doesn't see the RNA. The immune system sees the candy coating, the protein shell on the outside. And so when you make a vaccine, the first thing you have to do is you have to sequence the DNA in the virus so that you can then start creating the protein shell and start creating virus. And when they make vaccines, basically what they do is they take a lot of virus, think of M&Ms, they smash them up, and they melt away the chocolate. And then what is in the vaccine is that protein shell, the bits and pieces of that protein shell, because that's what your immune system needs to learn that's not supposed to be in your body, so that when it sees that protein shell later, it attacks it and eliminates it. That's how vaccines work. Now, in the old days, just being a handful of years ago, it took months to be able to create the building blocks of the vaccine. But with genome sequencing and all the advances there, that's now done in weeks. And so that has put us way ahead on the curve of vaccine production. So we've got vaccines that are at the point where they can be tested. So remember, this virus, the very first case of it that we looked at was on Christmas Eve. So here we are, you know, just a few months later, and we've already got a vaccine ready for human trial. That is light years faster than what we had just a decade ago. But now that we're in that phase, the testing needs to go just the way it did before, because you can't computer simulate this. So a small number of folks will be given the vaccine to make sure that they don't have some sort of an unexpected negative reaction to it. And if they don't, then we'll go to a larger group of folks. Basically, again, it's another safety evaluation. And then it'll go to an even larger group of folks to not only test the safety, but to see if it actually works in preventing those folks from getting sick. So that's generally three steps, because of phase 1, phase 2, and phase 3 trials. And then the phase 4 trial, which you'll hear about, is when it's actually gone to market and they monitor to see. So the fact that we are already in phase 1 trials in a virus that was just first recognized a couple months ago is miraculous. And we need to all be very happy about it. And let's hopefully move forward. But it's still going to be some time before it's ready for widespread use.